Hello, Airbus cockpit coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the iniBuilds A350, and in this video we're going to look at our descent preparation. Just been kicked out of the bunk and we're approaching 6 hours of flight time, so I'm coming in now to look at our descent preparation and ensure that we're ready for our arrival into John F. Kennedy. So you'll see from the OIS screen here we're approaching US East Coast, and we're just under 160 miles before our top of descent, so we want to ensure we're conducting this well in advance of our top of descent, making sure we're allowing good time to make the necessary preparations and prepare ourselves and get a situational awareness of our approach. So the first thing we want to do is make sure that we've got all the relevant up-to-date data in the aircraft. I come down to the init page here and just re-request the winds to make sure the system is using the latest data. Once we've requested the winds, we want to also insert them, and then we can check them out. So the descent winds are really interested in here, so they're now populated and updated. Then we come over to the ATC comms menu here, and we want to update our weather. Got the latest information for our arrival into John F. Kennedy and also our alternate aerodrome, Philadelphia. So we've got the latest weather here. Want to make note of that, and we'll need that later when we come to review our approach performance information. The altimeter's at 3029. So we can pre-select that here. 3029, and then we want to look at our charts. So we come into our terminal charts. We have pinned our arrival, which is the patch 3, RNAV into JFK. We've got our approach, which is the 31 left ILS, and then we've got our airport layout for reference as well. Want to run check here as also on ECAM status. We press the status button down here. It's all normal up there, so there's no new faults to be aware of. We want to calculate our landing performance just to make sure that we're capable of landing at John F. Kennedy today. So we sync our sim brief up here, and we sync the weather. We just want to make sure that the conditions here match what we've got in terms of the weather on the ground. So we're currently dry. Do a manual landing, and it's going to be autobrake medium. So that's the maximum. The manual is using the foot pedals down here, and that's generally the hardest form of braking, max manual. Medium will give you the maximum auto brake or brake to vacate braking available. And we've got the option up here as well to select whether we're going to be reversers or not. We'll leave reversers on today, and then we'll compute that. We've got a factored landing distance and our stop margin, so we've got plenty of space here on the runway today. It's a very long runway here, 31 left at John F. Kennedy. So we know we can land, which is great. Just calculated an approach speed of 146 knots. We can check that, cross-check that with our system calculations later on. Then we want to come up and make sure our EFIS is set up for our arrival. So we want constraints on, and we want to consider whether we want airports on around us, and weather or terrain. So we might have one of these on the first officer side, for example. The weather over there and terrain over this side. That's our preference. That all depends on, you know, what the conditions are, if weather's a factor or if terrain's a factor, or if they're both a factor. Then we want to come down and enter our runway reference. So we go to the perf page and position monitor, and we can type in KJFK 31 left. Enter. and that's a bearing and distance to the runway threshold. That's useful for quick reference. So I'm just going to put the weather in on that side while we put the performance data in for the arrival on this side as well. So we go to our approach front page here, we can put our winds in, which is 340 at 11 knots. My keyboard doesn't let me put minus figures in, so I'm going to use the KCCU for this. Put our altimeter, which is 3029, that's in inches rather than hectopascals. So what you can do, if we select 3029 up here, and we go across to QNH, it's 1026. That's a little cheat, working that one out. We want to enter our minimums, so move it to our terminal charts. All variants of the A350 are a Category Charlie aircraft, and they're all at 213 feet here today. So Barrow 213 and enter. Transition level 180 in the US. Put that bap speed there of 145. It's 146 there, so it's not hugely out. So I'm not concerned by that. So that's our approach performance information setup. Then we want to look at the go around. To our terminal charts, and typically for the go around we use the MSA, so we're at 2900 there on the climb out, so that's for our engine out, 2900, enter. Then we want to come to the init page and just check our fuel for the arrival, so we've got an extra 3.7 tonnes and 43 minutes, so happy with that. At this point we'd also consider setting up the secondary flight plan if it was likely that we had another runway which we may get switched to. We could enter that in here, or indeed shortcuts and things like that, so we could set up for free one right, for example, here if that was likely. One thing you want to be sure of on the secondary flight plan if you're setting up alternate approaches is to make sure that your performance data for this approach matches what we have in the active flight plan, and it needs to be identical, otherwise you may have issues transferring that data over should you need to activate the secondary. So that's just one thing to watch out for there. We also want to consider tuning any nav aids at this point as well, so we come to the nav aid button there. I'm happy to have them auto-tuned for this one, but if there's something specific you wanted to be tuned in, you can just select and type that in, and or type the frequency in. And we also want to do a check, let's put that back on the performance page, want to do a check of the airfield landing elevation, which is here on the upper screen. 0 feet there, it's pretty much at sea level, and we've got 13 feet airport elevation, so there or thereabouts, tolerance of 30 feet, it's fine. If it was way out, we certainly want to be checking our data that we've put in, so there shouldn't be a huge discrepancy. Next we want to set up our brake to vacate, so we zoom down, all the way down below 10 miles to the zoom section, and the airport map is now loading up. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more on that. So first of all, what we want to do is set the runway condition over here. So at the top here you'll see we've got dry code 6, and we can change that. So wet 5, snow, but we're dry today, so we want to make sure that's correct. We want to make sure we've got the green arrow here on the correct runway. And then, with reference to our chart over here as well, we'll be looking at where we want to vacate, so maybe something like Mike Delta. But obviously, if it's wet, we don't want it to be before the wet bar, so we'll always get the wet bar shown. So it's dry today, so that's our minimum distance for landing we needed. So we want to select something after that. If it was wet, obviously we need to select something after the wet bar there. So we should be good for Mike Delta. So we'll set brake to vacate exit. Once that's done, so we've selected the landing runway, we've chosen the runway state, we've selected the exit, we need to select brake to vacate and confirm BTV is armed on the FMA on the primary flight display. We do get some information here, so we've got exit, the distance down the runway. We've got turnaround time here as well, so we've got 70 minutes turnaround if we use reverse thrust, so that takes some of the heat off the brakes. We've got 100 minutes if we don't use reverse thrust, so the brakes will heat up, so they need a bit of cool down time. So we've got, we've got to have it in plan mode to see that. So we can zoom back out, that's brake to vacate set up. Once we've done all of that, we would then do our approach briefing. Now I have done a separate video on the Airbus approach briefing. It's standard across aircraft types, so I will link that in the video description so you can take a look at that. If you have any questions on the descent preparation, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.